Hello everyone. So in our previous video, I showed you what integration is, what it means by antiderivatives and a family of those, okay? And how integration gives you a family of the antiderivatives. In a couple of videos, I'll teach you how to integrate some basic functions. Alright? So in this video, I'll give you two standard results on integration. So here's the first one. Integral k times f of x dx is the same as k times the integral f of x dx. Okay, so k is a constant. For example, you need to find the integral of 3x dx. Okay, this is the same as 3x dx. Okay, now what is x dx? Well, integral x dx is x to the power of 1 plus 1 divided by 1 plus 1, so 3 by 2 x square plus some, well, this thing is actually x square by 2 plus c, okay? So we got 3x square and then we get 3 times c, and c is just, used to represent a constant. So 3 times c will also be a constant, so you can write it as c, okay? Now, where did this come from? Let us prove this. Okay, so let this integral be p of x. Okay, integral f of x dx be px. Okay, now by definition of integrals, this means that the differentiation of p of x is f of x. Okay, and now you can multiply both sides with this constant k. So you have k times differentiation of p of x is k times f of x. Alright, and now you can bring this k into our differentiation. We have studied using our rules of differentiation. So it is the same as d by dx of k times p of x is equal to k times f of x. Now you can think of this as your function, this entire quantity as your function, and this k times p of x as its antiderivative. So differentiate k times p of x, this function, to get this one. This means by the definition of integration, we get k f of x dx. Okay, we are considering k into f of x as one function, is equal to k times p of x. Okay, now it should be plus c here and plus c here, but this is the same property that everything, we can collect all the constants. So we are just neglecting the constants in this proof, but you can always write plus c at the end. So we have got this result, k times f of x is k times p of x, but what is p of x? It is integral fx dx. So this is the same as k goes outside the integral f of x dx, which is our original result. So this is our second result. Okay, so integral, you have sum or difference of two functions, f of x plus minus g of x dx, okay, is the same as you take the individual integrals and add or subtract them. For example, integral let us say x square plus x cube, okay, dx. Okay, this is obviously in the brackets. Now this is the same as you calculate the x square integral first, okay, and then add the x cube integral to it. Now this is the same as x to the power 2 plus 1 divided by 2 plus 1, so x cube by 3 plus x to the power 3 plus 1 4 divided by 3 plus 1, this is 4. Okay, and this will give you some constant You add these two constant, you will get another constant. You can simply write it down as c.
Okay, very useful.
Let us prove this result. Okay, so let the integral of f of x dx be let us say p of x, okay, and integral g of x dx be q of x, okay. Now this means that the derivative p of x is f of x, and derivative of q of x is g of x. Alright. Now if we add these two, what will you get? You will get d by dx p of x plus d by dx q of x is f of x plus g of x, okay, and if you subtract them you will just get a minus sign. So I'm doing both of them together, so plus minus plus minus. If you add them you will have the top thing plus plus on both sides. If you have minus subtracting them, then you will have minus on both sides of your equation. Okay, now this thing is the same as d by dx p of x plus q of x, okay, derivative of the combined function plus minus q of x p of x plus q of x, okay. This is same thing. Now you can think of this, okay, f of x plus minus g of x as your function, as one function, okay, and p of x plus minus q of x as another function. So if you differentiate this function, okay, take both of them taken as a whole, you will get these two taken as a whole, which means from our definition of integrals, integral f of x plus minus p of x dx, okay, put the brackets to make things clearer, will be these two functions, p of x plus minus q of x. Alright, and what is p of x and q of x? Well, if we go back, we'll see p of x is integral f of x dx and q of x is integral g of x dx. So this gives you integral f of x dx plus minus integral g of x dx. We have proved our result. So we can generalize our two results into a single result. Okay. So if we have k1 f1 x plus k2 f2 x plus so on till kn fn x. Okay. So n functions with their coefficients. So k1, k2, so on till kn. What you can do is you can split your integral. Okay. And take out your coefficients. So k1 times this individual integral plus k2 times this individual integral, so until your kn times this individual integral. Let me take an example. So say you want to integrate this integral 5 sine x minus cos x, okay, plus 3 e to the power x, you can just play with them, plus x square plus 1 by x dx, okay. Now this might look very long and lengthy, but you can split your integral into such smaller integrals, okay. So it is as good as integral 5 integral sine x dx minus integral cos x dx plus 3 times integral e to the x dx plus integral x square dx plus integral 1 by x dx. Alright, now what is integration of sine x dx? It is minus cos x, okay. So 5 remains as it is, minus cos x minus integration cos x dx, this is sine x plus 3 times e to the power of x dx. This is very special, it remains the same. So e to the power of x plus x square. Okay, so x to the n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. So x to the 2 plus 1, 3 divided by 2 plus 1, 3. So x cube divided by 3 plus integration 1 by x dx. This is ln x. Okay. So finally, from this we get minus 5 cos x minus sin x plus 3 e to the power x plus x cube by 3 plus ln x plus some constant. So today we studied two results on integration and we applied them. In my next video, we'll further see how to evaluate other integrals. Okay, thanks for watching. See you later.